Hello and welcome back to Thronebreaker! Time to actually head towards the main quest. Apparently we see a battle coming up. And the main quest is something we can actually reach. Well, actually very soon, but I kinda actually wanna go and around. Destroyed. I always like doing that.
As if nobody lifted a finger against the Nilfgaardians.
King surely ordered all his armies to return to Aldersburg, took cover behind its walls.
I do not wish to dismay, but after what we saw at Rossburg...
Enough doomsaying, Gascon.
Yeah, zip it! Let's see what we got. Oh. I'll explore this area a little bit more. Alright, apparently we're gonna have battle here. Against some bandits? Question mark? I don't know. Who knows? Maybe bandits, maybe not. We don't really know. That should be good. This is pretty powerful. Black Rayla actually showing up. do I need to have two units fighting each other? One Strays Bomber is pretty good. Or maybe we're just gonna go with this.
New orders? No?
Ooh, gain resilience. Wait, this is not a shortened battle. Right? Is it? It's not. It's not. Maybe I should just kill that.
This harvest will be reaping black clad heads.
Okay, let's just wait.
Must be an important lesson in this, but what?
It's not great.
My spirit's willing and how, but these damn boots are killing me.
Wanna do the meat flail? Pretty damn slew.
Wise choice.
So that's resilient already.
Ours is not to reason why.
We could be in trouble. Oh, yeah. But he has... Fine, this is fine. Because he does have a resilient guy. But because we spent 3 cards and he spent 3 cards, we can just pass and not care about the resilient guy. Yeah, that's what I like. Gonna pass. He doesn't have to do anything.
Hail Katzer!
Oh. More resilient guys.
A highly curious case.
Sure. I don't think that's gonna matter too much, but... definitely a good play on his part. Oh. We're just burning it? Oh, I forgot that's how it works now. In this version. Order! Oh, never mind that. Doesn't matter. Clear your incitement and use it right away.
A time to sow and a time to die.
Or we just wait a little bit. We can just wait the other incitement because these have a very strong loyalty bonus.
Life is mine now.
Okay. No! Oh, fuck. Alright, I messed up. We can still win, I think. But it's kind of impossible to say. let's just set the background fire.
This could hurt.
Oh, they're boosting? Whenever an ally appears, gain one charge. This unit has armor. Okay. We can just play the Lyrian Arbalest. And now it doesn't have armor anymore. We just need to do Regiment Drummer. Play a card from deck. Oh yeah, just bird in the back. That's fine by me.
Again and again.
I'm gonna move the banner. That we deal one more damage with the Arbalest. I don't think it's gonna matter.
Hail Herta.
Discard. Alright.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
I can hit that and move all in the back. We don't really have to min-max this. He doesn't have a chance. Let's see what we got. More archers. Force two units to duel. Reynardo though gets out booster guy.
Forward march!
But yeah, that's all we got. Nice. Let's move them in the back. He actually discarded the other pikeman now that he had in hand. A little awkward. A tiny bit awkward. It doesn't have anything to... It doesn't have two units. I can't use the dual card. Maybe I'm gonna do it anyway. Alright. We have a slight disadvantage
my
here.
Prescription, a bit of bloodletting.
I'll fight to my last breath.
Oh,
geez.
Delayed. Pushed him in the back. Well, okay. So this is the hardest difficulty, apparently. That's so bad because when you have these regular fights, it's stupidly easy. But when you have the puzzles, there's holy shit, there's like one solution and it's built in such a way that, you know, it's just, you gotta like wait at the start, like, I don't know, bust out the notepad or a piece of paper and just start thinking about this. Your Excellency, your orders have been fulfilled. We requisitioned over 30 head of cattle from the local population, slaughtered them, and left them under the sun. Once the carcasses have reached the appropriate level of rot, as determined by the medics of Vicovaro, they shall be sent to the front for the artillery division. Alright. How useful! So, starving the people just to possibly send in rotting cows. Use them in a siege. It doesn't really come up in
coming
games.
Across a small brook, Meave ordered her soldiers to replenish their water supplies.
Crusader.
When they returned, it was with empty water skins and troubled expressions.
Milady, the water tastes of blood. Not like black pudding, mind, but rancid. Filthy!
Meave had no choice but to march on. She gulped dryly and wondered how to interpret this strange event. An omen, perhaps? A warning from the gods?
She's not really a critical thinker, is she? It's like, oh, just tried to make up some bullshit explanation.
She soon learned the truth. Following the brook upstream, the Lyrians arrived at a small pool. Bobbing on its surface were dozens of corpses. A young woman caught Meave's gaze, her long hair spread delicately atop the water, wide open eyes reflecting the sky, a fine nose peppered with freckles,
and a gaping wound slashed across her throat.
We shall stop here,
the Queen said calmly,
and give these souls a proper burial. Reynard, send scouts. Tell them they are not to return until they ascertain what has happened here.
What? But the Afghanians killed a bunch of people and then threw them into the river?
When the scouts returned a while later, they brought with them a barefooted peasant they'd found hiding in the woods. They claimed he hailed from Horton, a nearby village, the village whose inhabitants had been murdered.
Then black-clad wretches stormed the village, milady. The devil free gave at the four. Rounded us right up, took us down to the lake. Whole village, mind. Then chop, chop, and splosh, splosh. It was I alone gave him the slip.
Holy crap, I managed to successfully figure out what happened. The New of Guardians killed a lot of people. The only thing I didn't know is Rygav did it. I suppose this peasant knows because he introduced himself, Rygav.
It's gonna make it easier. Tale, then placed him in the care of her medics and ordered the Lyrians to break camp. She rode at the head of their column, Reynard at her side, her knuckles gripped white on the reins.
Do we know where this Freegef is stationed?
Our riders report he's pitched camp to the east.
Then let's pay him a call.
What? We know the name?
Like Rosberg. My lady, please. Make them pay.
Kind of sounds like the resident zombie in the camp. Anyway, I'm actually quite surprised that we know the leader. Like, of course we send out scouts and we see some Nilfgaardian camps, of course. But we actually know who leads the camp. Unless the flag is a giveaway. I don't know how you would figure that out. Unless the peasants know, once again.
Milka,
it's not Bezra, impossible.
Kristan,
a little unlikely.
All killed. Souls snuffed out to the very last. Could have run for help, I know.
You can still have a proper village to yourself. What?
God damn it. It sounds like better now.
Anyway. So, Your Majesty, our scouts found a fresh grave not far from the village. Its engraving in Nilfgaardian seems an invader was laid to rest there. Judging by the tributes left, he must have been somewhat important. The Horton slaughter still has our soldiers livid, and they wish to destroy the grave. Shall we leave them to it? Oh, nice. Take everything of value, destroy the rest. Okay. Well, that well, I don't know. I'm kinda on the side of let's not disturb the graves. Take only the tributes, leave the rest untouched. Okay, let's just compromise here. Let's not dig up the grave. Okay? Let's just be reasonable. Why would we dig up a corpse, you know? For all we know, it might be, somehow sick, a sick person that was buried there. Like, the last thing we want is, come on, it's just pointless, come on. Will you really feel better about digging up some random person?
The Lyrians had no trouble finding Vrigif's camp. It was the size of a sprawling town. Meave stopped her caravan and called for a council. The first to speak was Reynard.
Seems our scouts were both right and wrong, Your Grace. They did pinpoint General Freegef, the Butcher of Horton. Unfortunately, they underestimated his detachment. It is much larger and better armed than our own.
We kill him. By the way, this is ridiculous. We've managed to find Vrygav, and like, well, in a minute. he was literally right here. Like, oh, wonder who did this. Oh yeah, that's the one. Also, they have a fourth for some reason. Well, we're just gonna
that
kill him.
That changes nothing,
Meave said, forestalling all protest.
If I leave him unpunished, without so much as an attempt, I shall never be able to face my reflection again. We must attack.
Reynard bowed and passed the order to the Lyrians. Later that same day, Meave and Vrigif's forces stood face to face on the field of battle.
Yeah, but why would they come out? Right? Oh, it's a shortened battle. I defeat the Nilfgaardian army or eliminate General Rygav. Okay. So we can win by points or we can win by killing a guy. Okay, not that. Force duo might actually work. Kill Vrygaff. Oh, Reynard Odo. Oh, that's gotta be pretty strong. I think this might be the winning hand. Yeah, this is fine by me. Actually, he's probably not gonna have a lot of units, but this is still good for me. Yeah, these are fine.
Come out, Frigeth!
Come on!
Can you pay for your crimes?
Time to pay up! Okay, we're gonna do Illyrian Sightman. After an ally is destroyed, move to its position.
My spirit's willing and
we're just gonna hit right away.
You are dogs!
There! Frigga! I see him! We've gotta catch him!
Yeah, we're catching him.
There's a time to reap, a time to sow.
What is he doing? Damage the lowest Price ally by choice. 10 and boost the highest ally by 5. Okay. Questionable maneuver. Rygaff. Let's go like that.
Order!
The Horsens.
Okay. Maybe do Rivian Pikeman plus.
Lyrian Lummoxes.
Then get out the Lyrian Arbalest. We're just gonna play Vrygaff Foot Soldiers non-stop. Yeah, feel free to kill that.
Arbalist at your command.
Ah! Yeah, busting down the gates. It's probably not gonna happen. We can even kill Vrygaff. At this rate. Keeping the dual card would have been pretty helpful with that.
Army's a waste of time for one like me.
What now, Rygaff? Wait, what? Are they all immune now? Can I act? Well, we can't directly attack him, but... Actually, I kinda messed up. Let's hit this. What? Oh yeah, I left, gotta play a little bit more.
Right, left, right.
Try Gif! I don't think he would have joined me. Actually, I'm just gonna kill everybody because the fire deals so much damage. But they're already on fire, that's not gonna work.
I smell a leak.
I can spell, I can set a fire to the first row.
We must trust each other.
Okay. We can just win by doing this.
Got right. Him! The rest should surrender before long.
He would have died anyway.
The Lyrians won the day, despite their foe's distinct advantage. Historians later ascribed Meave's victory to her light troops' superior maneuverability in the difficult terrain compared to the plate-clad Nilfgaardians. But if you ask me, that wasn't it at all. A storm of fury had been quietly gathering in the Lyrians' hearts, A squall of rage stoked by the Nilfgaardians' unparalleled cruelty towards the conquered. And no one embodied this barbarism more perfectly than General Frigif. Meave's men were ready to sacrifice anything to see him punished.
Or alternatively, I set the entire fort on fire, aka the back row, and dealt a lot of damage to him. No, that was definitely not it. Also, Meave was swinging the hammer, mace, or whatever. Like, non-stop.
They dragged the defeated general before Meave. The queen wished to learn why he'd ordered the execution of an entire village. How the Nilfgaardians could possibly justify such a crime.
2 weeks prior, I'd sent a detachment to Horton to procure feed. Captain Gaynor commanded it. While he was verifying their grain stores, they barricaded him in the barn and put it to flame.
The queen listened to the general's story, her face a mask, betraying nothing.
Murdered. One man was murdered.
While attempting to steal. Wow, that's so crazy. How could such a thing happen? While attempting to steal with an army at his back.
Frigif raised his eyes to Meave's. The queen was surprised to see them wet with tears.
Yes, what? My lady. My son.
The general's simple words bore pain, grief, and a thirst for revenge that would never be slaked. The queen had to decide what to do with Frigif. No doubt the general had earned punishment, the harshest possible at that. Yet, such a weighty personage could fetch a hefty ransom, and Meave's army desperately needed the gold.
All right. Well, we can. My thing is, I don't value, okay, this is just one guy. As much as I wanna, I think killing you would be good, but if he can sell you, we're gonna sell you.
In the end, the queen decided to return the general for a golden ransom.
How much money?
She chose the path out of mercy.
If you get like 10 gold, I'm gonna be mad.
Or out of pure material calculation, sensing an excellent chance to replenish her war chest, it is hard to say. One thing is certain. Her men were crestfallen at the news. They had challenged Frigif's greatly superior forces in the name of justice, not gold.
How the hell did we only get 400 gold? That's the silly part here, is that... Why? I would want to know how much money I get. If I get, 5,000 gold, alright, I guess we can consider it. Actually, I don't need gold. The way the game works, you don't need gold ever. We could have considered the morale as well, because... But yeah, we're just giving him back, it's just fun, right? We can still kill him. And that gold can help us get stuff. If we could have traded him for supplies, now that would have been hilariously amazing. I'm not sure if he can actually use the gold. Effectively. But if you can trade him back for supplies, now that's more like it. Because imagine that. Trading back one guy just to actually help. That would actually help our war effort. We'll just pick this up. I'm not sure about the gold here. Look at this. I already found 3,000 gold. And why sell him for 400 gold? But I already found 3,000 gold. That's just kind of how it works. Everything is on fire, but this is pretty unlikely though, because okay, fine, fire. But thing is, the thing is just not gonna stay on fire for that long. Okay, they set it on fire, fine, but everything is on fire non-stop. It's not gonna burn forever. Oh, what we have here? Oh, we can go there. Also, we can go to the city. Oh, actually, we're getting damn close. We managed to take out Rygaff. Take out his camp. I think it would be a little bit more realistic if it was, all black fields. Everything's burned down, black trees. I mean, of course we see some of that, but everything is currently on fire. And like non-stop. But like, yeah. We go through this entire area and everything is on fire. So unless an army is like setting fire to everything just as we about to arrive, it seems a little unlikely. Anyway guys, thanks for watching and see you next time.